Hello there and welcome to the Business Roundup this week. I am Viola Ksasia and joining us is Paul Busharizi. We are going to be looking at the trending events in the world of business. But first, happy Eid to you all our Muslim viewers. Let's dive in, starting with KCCA, who seem to be a huge topic right now on Twitter over potholes in the city. So thank you, Paul, for making time. Let's start again. As I mentioned with KCCA, it's just such a hot topic at the moment, the potholes in the city. What do you have to say about the response that KCCA gave out, and was that the smart way to answer critics by posting a road, just one, when everybody's talking about their home roads and how bad they are? Does one road really solve the problem that is evident, the potholes in the city?
I think, first of all, KCCA is actually the victim in this situation. KCCA has roads under KCCA has roads to under its control, whatever. But unfortunately for KCCA, because the roads are there, but they have to be maintained. But KCCA is not given an adequate budget to maintain the roads. So KCCA asks for, at this last year, which is just ending, 76 billion shillings. But they only got about, I think, 14 billion shillings for maintenance. So, of course, as night follows day, you know, this is going to be the consequence. Of course, cases are getting the bashing, but they're only just the messengers. The horse has already bolted the barn. Essentially, the bad news is out. All this stuff they were saying about, you know, putting out pictures of good roads in Kampala, that should have been done before. So that by the time we get into this other campaign highlighting potholes, enough of us would be able to give them the benefit of doubt. You see, this other side, what? But you see, coming after the fact, maybe shoddy work, shoddy PR.
It's very great that you point out that KCCA seems to be the victim at the moment. They don't receive enough budgets for the roads, especially maintenance. And the president mentioned giving 6 billion per quarter to be able to, you know, first lift the roads at least. But do you see the 6 billion working for making sure the roads are stable, at least to the Ugandan citizens' standards or requirements?
So 6 billion per quarter then becomes 24 billion per year. But as I said earlier, KCCA's budget for maintenance alone is 76 billion. So essentially they should be getting 19 billion every quarter for maintenance. So you can see what's going to happen again with the 6 billion, you know. You'll cover in soil, you'll cover the potholes in soil, and within the next rain they're washed out and we're back to potholes again. I think what they're hoping for also is that there's a huge, we've talked about before, a huge road infrastructure rehabilitation project. It's already signed off. It's actually, the contractors have already started mobilizing, you know, resources to start doing. They were supposed to have started in February. They did start in February. So before the end of this year, we'll already see a lot of construction work going up in Kampala. So maybe that might pacify us for a few more months. But again, the maintenance budget is so much less than it should be, and you can expect the potholes story will be with us for a long time to come.
One of the trending issues at the moment is maybe the progress in the iron sheets scandal. The iron sheets that were meant for Karamoja and the people that took them that were implicated in this scandal, some of them have been to court. Events keep on unfolding. So some Ugandans have concern that maybe you cannot trust any leader with that kind of money, that even the 6 billion, even though it's small for KCCA to maintain roads, it's just not something you can give to someone and expect them to give you results. What have we become, and what can you comment about the corruption that's prevailing at the moment, and how best can we receive services as taxpayers?
Well, we probably can't talk about many of the cases in particular because they're before court right now. But when I looked at the whole thing, you talk about 12,000 iron sheets, that's about, which are under question or something. When we did the math using their figures, their figures show that an iron sheet is 71,000, although on the open market it might be under 50,000. It comes to under 850 million shillings. And in the greater scope of corruption in Uganda, that is one minister's take or whatever the case may be in other cases. But it's symbolic of how bad corruption has become in this government, that, you know, ministers stoop as low as stealing iron sheets from the Karimi Jonk. That's really the big deal with this story.
All right, Paul, so government released money for the last quarter. So what are some of your comments about the progress so far in the new financial year? How far do you think we've gone with the service delivery that maybe we expected at the start of this, the budget announcement prior to the quarter?
No, I mean, Secretary of the Treasury, Ramadan Gobi, this week released the last quarter tranche of money to government agencies and stuff like that. 9.3 trillion, not sadly, but the reality is that 4.2 trillion of it goes to paying debt. So you're now left with 5.1 trillion. And then he gave 14 billion to pay to pay arrears, you know, public arrears, which is so sad because the public arrears now are up to 8 trillion shillings. So 14 billion is not even a drop in the ocean. This is like...
All right, Paul, so thank you so much for joining us once again this Friday, and we hope to see you more times to be able to help us with the business events happening and making sense of them. Thank you very much for making time to catch the Business Roundup once again. We happen to have the Business Roundup every Friday here on the news. And I am Viola Sasia. Until next time, have a good night.